All right, welcome everybody to the My Lifetime in Music series, the series in which I listen to every single number one song of my lifetime ever since I was born, ever since I've been alive. This is a very interesting one. I have absolutely no knowledge of this song whatsoever, which I'm not saying I'm a genius and I know everything about music. But I think if, you know, if a song is number one, you know what I mean? Like I probably would have heard of the song before. This is one that I know nothing about. We've had a very interesting back catalogue so far. I've made a Spotify playlist with, like, as we go week by week, you know, we're adding the songs and stuff. It's a strange playlist so far. Last week was the strangest of them all. What song knocked Barbie Girl off number one? It was Perfect Day by the BBC. Various artists, songwriter Lou Reed, produced by Stephen Kelenak. No idea what this is. Let's have a wee read and let's find out what this is all about. In 1997, the BBC made a version of the song with advertising agency Legas Delaney. It showcased the BBC in a lengthy corporate promotion of its diverse music coverage, which was broadcast on BBC channels, in cinemas, and at major events organised by the BBC, such as the Eurovision Song Contest. It featured Lou Reed himself and other major artists in what the Financial Times described as an astonishing lineup of world-class performers. Interesting. In reference to the license fee, the film ends with a message: whatever your musical taste, it is catered for by the BBC Radio and Television. This is only possible thanks to the unique way the BBC is paid for by you. BBC, you make it what it is. With the current stuff that's going on with the BBC and paying the telly license, this is very relevant. Interesting. Okay, promoted by huge public demand, the track was released on November 17th, 1997 as a charity single for children in need. And Reed commented, "I have never been more impressed with a performance of one of my songs." Now we're talking. Okay, just by reading up on this, I'm already interested. Let's find out who's in this. So we have Lou Reed himself, Bono, big name, Sky Edwards, David Bowie, Elton John, Suzanne Vega, Andrew Davis, Boyzone, some big names, a few others that I'm not as familiar with, Huey Morgan, Dr. John, Britt Anderson, Tom Jones. Very interesting. All right, there you go, everybody. There's a little bit of background on the song. Let's check out the song. And this is apparently ripped from a VHS, so it's not going to be the best quality. But now we know a little bit about it. It's a charity single for children in need, featuring Bono, David Bowie, Tom Jones, Elton John. Sounds good, here we go. I have no idea, I don't even know if I've ever heard this before. Here we go.
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the car, and then later when it gets dark,
it is.
We go home. Just a perfect day.
Here we go.
Feed animals in the zoo. Then later a movie too. And then
all right.
I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on.
All right.
You just keep me hanging on.
I have plenty to say already. Jeez. Okay, so 2022 is just turned 3 months old. We're now in March. And Elton John has been on the channel twice. Can you believe it? Never before on the channel. And now he pops up twice. Thank you, Elton, for your attention. Also popping up in lots of singles recently in modern music. Alright, again, very late 90s and early 2000s. I can understand that. Obviously, you know, this is going through the singles since I was born. This is like episode 5 or 6 of this series. So obviously, I wasn't, you know, I was a few months old at this point. So that's probably why I don't remember the song. Even to this day. Don't think I've heard this song before, which is a first, can you believe it? On the channel, for this series, I thought, you know, we're doing all the number ones. I'm going to be familiar, at least I would have heard the songs we're going to be reacting to. But, you know, as exampled right here, there's going to be some I've never heard before. You know, a few things to point out. What, I mean, look at the Harmony Styles here. And here's Bono. And by the way, U2 were a huge band. I guess they still are. But, I mean, early 2000s to mid-2000s, you know, Beautiful Day was such a massive, massive song. One of my favourite songs of all time, actually. And I wonder if we'll get to that. When did that come out? Like 2001, 2002? I'd love to get to Beautiful Day by U2. But anyway, he's standing here singing. Look. There's a second clip of him. Where was it? He's there. He's standing there. And he looks absolutely bored. Doesn't want to be there. I think that was like his style. You know, didn't want to be there. I don't know. And then Bowie just pops up, you know, as eccentric as ever. Just looking like a boss. My God. Interesting. All right, and then this is a look. This is a look, and I don't know who this guy is. But we will see. Just keep me hanging on. Check out Real Snow. Just a perfect day. Nice.
Weekenders on our own.
It's such fun. Made me forget myself. I thought I was someone else.
Someone good.
Yeah.
It's such a perfect day.
Nice. There's Bono waking up again.
You're going to read just what you sow.
Nice. This is strange. I mean, these lyrics. Here he is. Yes. Whatever your musical taste, it is catered for by BBC Radio and Television. This is only possible thanks to the unique way the BBC is paid for by you, by us.
A perfect day.
I like that, alright, good message. And the song has a nice message and stuff. It's not that great though, I mean the writing isn't that good whatsoever. Like, I don't know, how many weeks was this number one? 2 weeks in number one, alright. It's not that great of a song itself. It's a nice message and stuff, and there's some big names in it, obviously. But do you not think, see, like, I was talking about, like, these backgrounds, like, Bono standing there, and the one Tom Jones is standing in. Like, look at that. And that, so why was, like, the late 90s and early 2000s all about this? You'd see this all the time, especially, like, the BBC. You'd see loads of kids' shows and stuff, and videotapes and all that stuff, with this sort of background around that time. More so early 2000s, but this is still, you know, 1997. Very interesting. Also, Perfect Day. For some of you, you know that I have my movie podcast. I'd love you all to listen to it. The Good Bit podcast. You can find it every single Friday here on CM42 TV. Video versions, but you can also listen to the audio version on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Anchor, all the other podcasting platforms and stuff. And we recently talked about... Oh, just knocked the camera. We recently talked about Legally Blonde, the 2001 film. And the first song in that, Perfect Day... You know, when I first read Perfect Day on my phone for, you know, this particular video today, I was like, oh, is it that song? But it's not, obviously. It's this BBC collab thing. And do you not think when, like, there's this big collaboration of artists, you know, I think about, you know, like, Band Aid, Live Aid, We Are The World. Even recently, there was one in the UK that came out right at the start of the COVID pandemic and stuff like that, when COVID became a thing. We were all locked down. The Foo Fighters song, Times Like These... Amazing song. They did like a kind of collab version of lots of like artists, mainly based in the UK, with like Dua Lipa, Anne-Marie, Mabel, Coldplay, Ragged Bone Man, things like that. And they did like a kind of like collab with that, and it was like it was a big deal, obviously, because of like the nature of, you know, what was going on at the time. But you think back to like Band Aid and stuff being this thing that totally changed the world, and We Are the World, and you know all this stuff, like with the biggest songs of all time. You know, Do You Know It's Christmas, things like that. These songs like broke all these records and stuff and became some of the biggest selling songs ever, and it was such a big deal. Like, if you were to get all the biggest artists right now and you put them on the one song, would it change the world the way those songs did? And quite frankly, the answer's no, because they've done songs like this that have been totally forgotten about. And I don't know who the biggest, you know, music people, personalities were in 1997. I guess we're reacting to a few of them here. Obviously, the UK is going to be different than worldwide. But, like, I've never heard of this song before, and I've never heard this song before. I can imagine, though, people in, you know, their 20s and 30s, in 1997 would probably remember this song quite fondly because of the message and promoting it, like, okay, this is the sort of stuff that's being catered to by you because you pay for the BBC and things like that. So very interesting. Those are some thoughts anyway about this one. It's not by any means something that's really blown me away, and it's like now my life is changing. I have a clearer vision of the world because I heard this song. You know, they could have did so much more with it. You know what I mean? Like, I think I'd like to think if right now, you know, in 2022, we got the biggest artists, not just in the UK, but from around the world, much like We Are the World and Live Aid and Band Aid and stuff like that, and we put them all together, we would have an amazing thing, you know. But, like, it happens all the time, and sometimes you don't even hear about it because, you know, it's not even that big of a deal. You get artists collabing all the time, but if we can get, like, the biggest artists in the world, you know, and put them all in one song, would that have an effect like those ones did in the 80s? Because the one in 97 clearly didn't, you know, which is really interesting. But anyway, that was interesting. This is what this series is for, you know, discovering songs and music that was like a moment in time. Like, this is so 97, you know, clearly, because it's the biggest artist in the UK on the one song, you know. So, very interesting. Glad we did this one. Hopefully we'll have some more like this, but I've not even heard anything about the thing. We can read up on it, we can learn about it, and then we'll have a video. But anyway, thanks very much for watching and listening. Take care of yourselves. I'll see you all next time.